So we're here today with Robert Buxbaum, who is running for Oakland County Water Resources Commission. Did I get that right?
That's right. Robert Buxbaum.
Now, can you talk a little bit about what the Oakland County Water Resource Commissioner does?
Basically, we're responsible to get you clean, potable drinking water at a pressure that's suitable for firefighting. And we're responsible to take care of your sewage. Mostly it's the sewage for most of Oakland County nowadays. And that's basically when you flush your toilet, it should go where it's supposed to, into a plant that cleans it all up. Mm-hmm. And when the storms come, you know, it shouldn't flood the highways.
Now, why are you running for this position?
Well, I'm an engineer, and I was sick of griping about the stupid things I saw being done. You know, you gripe and you say, well, I could do this better. Oh, look at that. And after a while, you decide to do something about it.
Now, what are some of those things?
Well, some of it's what's being done that I thought shouldn't be done. Like they're building a giant, what's called tunnel cistern under Middle Belt, which is a technology that really doesn't belong there and it's just awful. And tying up traffic, and I don't think it'll ever work right. And then there's things that should be done that aren't being addressed. Like we end up, like the flood of 2014, which looks like it's based on, well, bad flow control and just bad drainage and just other things that really got me annoyed. And then in the summer, you'll notice that the beaches are closed just about every other week. Last year, 2015, it was closed more or less as often as it was open. And that's because we dump sewage, nearly raw sewage, into our lakes, into our rivers, a lot into Lake St. Clair. That's not right. We should be doing a lot better than that. And we can. It's just, I'm an engineer and I think I can. Mm-hmm. And if you don't know engineering, there's nothing you can do. You just sort of sit there and say, oh, act of God. Oh, another week, another act of God. And you say, no, it's an act of your stupidity. You get out of the chair. I'll tell you what should be done. And
so are there
that's what I'm doing.
Nice. So are there specific changes that you would make to fix those things?
Some of them are relatively big changes and some of them are relatively small changes. I'll talk about one of the big ones, which just because it's an opportunity. Our sewage, all of Oakland County's sewage, for the most part, heads down to Detroit. Some exceptions that we treat ourselves, but for the most part, it goes down to Detroit. And a lot of that is rainwater plus, like, what's called sanitary sewage. You know, you flush your toilet, your potato peelings, your lint from your washing machine. And so, for instance, this is the main pipe path, the Oakland-Macomb Interceptor Drainage, and it goes down to Detroit on via this pipe that's good, oh, I'd say 30 feet below ground level, and it's heading south, and it's not, you'll say, going downhill. So that's the pipe, and that's the height. But the land itself, as you can see, slopes the other way. It slopes uphill, you know, where the pipe is, which is to say that the land between, let's say, 8 Mile and 14 Mile slopes towards the Clinton River or the Red Run River, which is to say slopes directly north. And what I'd like to do, instead of having all of our rainwater go south to Detroit, and of course there's a big pump here to keep this going because it can't always go against gravity, I'd like it to go north on a pipe close to the surface to the river so you don't have as much flooding. And what's the big opportunity here is that Brooks Patterson has announced that he'd like to widen I-75, and he's already begun doing stuff in that, and that's like a once in a generation opportunity to get the drainage right. You do the drainage right, the highway won't crumble. I guess that was one of the things that got me into it in the first place, complaining about highways crumbling.
Oh, the roads.
Yeah, I mean, not only won't the highway crumble, but you won't have the flooding either.
Right.
And that's sort of a two-for-one trick that's been known since Roman times. You know, like, your highway really should be a big, like, drain with a highway on top of it. And there's some parts that'll be a little bit more difficult than others, but basically that's an opportunity that I want to be in on. I think I, you know, if you do it right, our bills will be lower, our highway will last better, and we won't have the flooding. So, you know, I want to be there doing it. There are a lot of smaller issue things, but that's, I guess, one of the biggest ones.
Now, you talked about the I-75 widening project and that that's an opportunity. Are you familiar with what they are doing there and what the plans are?
Well,
is Brooks considering
when I started running, I met with Brooks. I met with him before and griped, but then I wasn't a candidate. I was just a, you know, an engineer griping at him, and mm-hmm. you know, I'm sure it got shelved as a lot of other people's gripes. It got taken seriously. I think it's, as I've told, it's on the list of things they're looking at. So, and if you look at it, you'll see it's the way to go. So.
What about the cost of implementing that?
Well, you've got to put on down some sort of foundation. And that's why you have to look at it, I guess. You do have to do the economics, but I'm pretty sure that, as Roman engineers found, and English and French and everyone else has found, that's the way to go. You save money in the, certainly in the long term, and I think you save almost from the very beginning, because we pay a ton to treat rainwater when it goes down to Detroit. If we can reroute it straight up into the Clinton River, we don't pay a dime to treat it.
Why would we be treating it then?
Well, it's just rainwater. The reason we treat it in Detroit is it gets mixed with the sanitary sewage, your potato peelings and your flush, right. toilet flush, and then it all has to be treated in the big plant by Zug Island. A really bizarre pipe. I'm sure it made sense when it was put in, you know, 70, 100 years ago.
Right.
But I think I've got a map of the piping system. These are the rivers. Most of our rivers are great, by the way. I don't want to gripe too badly. There's Oakland County. The red ones are the polluted ones. The yellows are sort of bad. You know, these are Mercury Lakes. But for the most part, we're nice and clean. So you don't want to be too negative on that.
What about when you... the cities that have combined systems, you couldn't reroute them that way, could you?
That's the point, is you want to uncombine them, but you don't want to just go in and rip out everything. You want to start by putting an artery for the rainwater, and then you bit by bit want to connect to that artery.
Okay.
And the best artery I can imagine is this widened I-75. You know, there are other arteries you could go with, but that's the one. Mm-hmm. You know, it just diagonally cuts right through the county. It's just too good an opportunity to pass by.
Now, do you have any other big ideas like that?
Got quite a few other big ideas. Some of them are already in, some of them are tweaks on things that are already there. Some of them are, like, here, Woodward Road. See, Woodward has a very nice green sward in the middle, quite busy, a lot of rain comes on it, and it has something that's sort of annoying, but it by necessity has it, called a curb. So what happens is when the rain falls on Woodward, it never gets the green sward. It's stopped by that curb there. And you can't get rid of a curb because there are cars, and the cars need the curb. But there is a plan, and I heartily embrace it, of putting in something called a bicycle lane. Now, a bicycle lane is very interesting. A bicycle lane needs something of a curb between it and the street, but usually it's not a hard curb because bicyclists need to turn every now and again. And on the other side of the bicycle lane, there's no necessity to have a curb. In fact, you can have what's called porous cement on the bicycle lane because bicycles are lighter than cars. So all of a sudden you have the opportunity to use rainwater and put it back into the water table. And that's not unique to me. I'm not the first engineer to have thought of it, applied it, whatever. But, you look at Woodward and you say, that's how I'd like to implement it. And there's a new directive out of Lansing that, again, I heartily endorse because that really is the sort of thing that got me involved, of working on the highways and the drainage underneath as one project rather than separate projects. And that was something that had bugged me. You'd drive along, let's say, Greenfield Road, which is a county road, and it would be fine, then bum, 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 bum. And to me, that meant there's leaky drain pipes underneath. Could be leaky water pipes underneath. It's very hard to tell what's going on. But, if it's smooth up till now and all of a sudden, it's falling apart, that was my guess as to what was happening. Mm. That all of a sudden you're driving on mud, and the reason you're driving on mud is that a water pipe is leaking, or sometimes it turns into a sinkhole, sometimes the other way around. It's a leaking drain pipe, so the rain just keeps on sucking the mud and the sand into the drain pipe until all of a sudden the road underneath the dirt underneath your road is gone. So either one can cause the road to be miserable, but then the state or the county would come in, fix the road, but they wouldn't fix the drains because one was the road department and the other was the drain department, and it was insane. So there's a new directive to work together, and that's long overdue, and it's something I really, really want to do. When you rip out the road, for God's sake, check the drainage underneath. It's, just makes sense.
So can you talk a little bit about your political history? Have you run for office before? Or?
This is my first time running for office, for any office. I'm a precinct delegate for the Republicans.
Okay.
But aside from that, my only political activism was I was class president in junior high school and in high school and in graduate school for the graduate students. So that's all of my political activism, and that was like 40 years ago. And then nothing, basically, for the next 40 years because, Oakland County's run pretty well, and I was in Lansing. I thought Lansing was run pretty well, and unless I'm needed for something, I'm not needed for something.
Right.
And then I was more and more annoyed at how the drainage was here, and I tried to get involved, and basically was told by the Democrats to run things. That was I used to be a Democrat, by the way.
Oh.
We really don't need you. We have enough people. We get elected our guys, and you're not needed, and your opinion isn't really needed either. And I said, I don't think the sewage cares. I don't think the sewage is too political, and I wanna get involved. I wanna fix the sewage. So. Bye. I'll do it my way.
So is that why you switched from the Democratic Party to the Republican?
No, I switched like 20, 30 years ago. The big problem was a fellow, Jimmy Carter was like, I campaigned for him, like, of course, it was 40 years ago.
Yeah.
I campaigned for him, and I thought he'd be great, and he was absolutely, unbelievably awful in every way possible. And I saw the things I didn't like in Jimmy in subsequent Democrats. Mm-hmm. Not all, some were fine, but like a lot of them had this, I'm going to save the world by like ruining you, and it's like, no, that's not right. And there were some weird Republicans. They're not the God's gift to the world, but as I got older, I became more Republican. I went from being a conservative Democrat to a liberal Republican. I don't think that's an unusual path.
Right. So you brought up being an engineer.
Yes.
And can you talk a little bit about what some of your experience has been?
I have a knack for engineering. Grew up in New York, and New York has is a big system. It has very fine what's called tracking. They have science high school, Bronx High School of Science, produced some very good physicists. I went to a high school in Brooklyn, Brooklyn Technical High School. In my day, produced 6,000 engineers, more or less. Now it's got 8,000. And it just gave you a very good program in math and engineering centric. There was a movie called Fame about the High School of Music and Art, which is, like real focused, high level stuff. And then I got into a free private college called Cooper Union. Peter Cooper designed the water system of New York. They were very proud of it. 1850s water system of New York. It's improved since then. Little changes here and there. Got a bachelor's in engineering there. Went to Princeton for my PhD in chemical engineering. Taught chemical engineering at Michigan State. And one of the nice things at Michigan State was it was really beautiful how they handled water and sewage. You can do it in New York, it's basically hidden. It's beautiful to an engineer, but it's not beautiful to anyone else. And in Michigan State, they had like rivers and dams, and I'd like to do some of that in Oakland County too. I mean, one of the things here, this is called a weir dam. It's a way of handling water flow. There's something of a weir dam right about in the middle of Michigan State campus. And it's something I would like to put a little bit more into Oakland County. It could make it look a lot nicer. We've put a lot of our rivers underground. And I would like to try daylighting a little of that. And it's good engineering and it's beautiful. If you do your engineering right, it's like a work of art. And you have to have a feel for it. You have to have an idea. This is where I want to go. And the fellow I'm running against, I don't think he has the feel for what he can do, what he can't do, how he can get from here to there. I suspect that I have the same goals as him. It's just, I know how to get there and I don't think he does.
Now, so is that why you think people should vote for you then?
Yeah, I mean, I know what I'm doing. I guess it's the basic, I put little problems and questions in my blog. I have a blog, I have a Facebook and a website. I say, here are some problems that someone in the water department should be able to answer. They're not that difficult, but there you go. And people are not as comfortable with it. It's just, my most recent one was on the chemistry of sewage treatment. Okay, so there's a chemistry to it. And if you know the chemistry to it, you won't be buffaloed by contractors. But if you do know it, you can see things, you can smell things, they're talking and you're looking and you're saying, yep, I'm not buying that. So I went to the Pontiac sewage treatment plant this morning. It's the biggest one that I'll be operating. I won't personally be operating, I'll be overseeing in Oakland County. And it was running a lot better than I thought it would. Actually, it was running quite nicely. But there are things that could be improved, and it helps to understand what you're looking at. And I'm making a trip to every one of the sewage plants of Oakland County. So like the bridges of Madison County, I'm doing the sewage plants of Oakland County. And it helps to know what you're looking at, what can be changed, what should be left alone. And most of what I'm seeing should be left alone. It's quite decent. So.
You live in Oakland County. Whereabouts in Oakland County?
I live in Oak Park.
And
we were hit by that horrible flood of 2014, yes.
Indeed, indeed.
And I suspect I know why that flood came, but I would like to speak. Once the people don't feel like they're going to be fired for bad-mouthing their boss, I guess I'll get the real story.
You suspect that it didn't happen the way that they're...
I mean, it was a big rain, no doubt about it, but there's big rains and there's big rains. I mean, 696 was flooded past the tops of the cars. You know, big rain, I can understand, flooded to the door. I even understand for a big rain, it shouldn't go to the top of the car. I'm sorry, you know, like, if that's not, you know, there was backups all over the place, and sewage and rainwater coming together up my basement, other people's basement, you know, Greenfield Road, which is a county road near me, flooded again to the tops of the cars. It was just appalling, and you know, that's just not supposed to happen. And I can suspect there's something called a bar screen that they just didn't connect the bar screen to the flow meters because they don't understand flow meters at that volume. Yeah, it's a little tricky, but it's, again, it's 1,000-year-old technology, so it shouldn't be that tricky.
Now, are you involved in your community at all?
A little bit. I don't have very many hobbies, I'm sorry to say. Very occasionally, I've gone for like miniature golf or something, and, you know, religious services, but I don't have an awful lot of hobbies. I plant vegetables, make my own wine, make my own Applejack, which is a Revolutionary War technology that's fallen into disuse. But so.
Now, if people want to know more about you, you mentioned earlier you have a blog.
Yes.
What is your blog called?
Okay, I have, let's see, I have a blog called rebresearch.com/blog. I had a blog for years because I started about 3-4 years ago. I was griping and griping. My son said, instead of griping at me, why don't you just start a blog? And I'm like, okay, so I did. And the last year or so is a lot to do with sewage and brains, and you know, occasionally I'll post other Republican-ish ideas, some more conservative than others. I also have Elect Buxbaum on Facebook, you know, Facebook/ElectBuxbaum, and I have a website called electbuxbaum.com, and electbuxbaum.com is pretty, it's not that static, but it has, you know, more things directly in the election stuff. The Facebook electbuxbaum is, you know, what am I doing today, so this interview appears there, and that I was going out to the Pontiac wastewater treatment plant this morning is there, and that I'll be attending some sort of meet and greet the candidates this evening in Waterford. That's, you know, so that's what I do with the Facebook stuff. And so there's the blog, there's that, and then there's the ElectBuxbaum, yes, general stuff. If you want to volunteer, and I could use a campaign song if someone out there would know. Right now, we've got the song of the Cebu, because Cebu is short for Committee to Elect Buxbaum, so it's Cebu.
Oh, nice.
Yes. see that thing there? There's a Cebu.
Oh, okay.
That was my Cebu, Committee to Elect Buxbaum.
Zoom in on that. There we go.
Yeah. Some people said it didn't look much like a Cebu, so I've evolved the Cebu to have bigger horns now. This is the new and improved Cebu with horns that are bigger. If you want to own that. Well,
there we go.
For a mere $2 donation, that beautiful pin can be yours. Or if you meet me, you don't even have to give the donation. For the mere price of a handshake, that pin could be yours.
Nice, nice, nice. Well, thank you so much for coming out and talking about your campaign with us today.
Okay, thank you.